So you thought triple lens cameras were hot, did you? Well, boom baby, how about five of the suckers? HMD Global has finally unleashed the Nokia 9 PureView, boasting a penta-lens Zeiss branded camera slapped on their back. We'll be bringing you a full rundown of that camera hardware and features in just a moment, but to be massive teasers, let's take a full tour of the rest of the phone, its hardware and specs as well. And don't forget, for more on the latest and greatest mobile tech, to bug subscribe and ding that notifications bell. Cheers. So when it comes to the construction of this smartphone, the Nokia 9 PureView is made from 6000 series aluminium, and you get a nice slab of Gorilla Glass 5 covering the front and the back surfaces as well. The phone is just 8mm thick and it's certainly quite comfortable to grip. It may lack a proper sexy premium finish that you might expect around this sort of price point, but it definitely still looks quite neat. Unfortunately, you do only get the one color option, however, midnight blue, though we are expecting some other variants to be released after the launch. Here's hoping for a nice bit of copper action. While most smartphone manufacturers are obsessed with filling the entire front of their phones with screen space, HMD Global seems to be perfectly happy for the Nokia 9 to rock a more old school vibe. Not a notch or pinhole camera in sight. As for that display, there's a 6-inch Quad HD Plus P-OLED panel. It's crisp and it produces nice punchy images, complete with full HDR10 playback. You can actually mess around with the color settings as well to suit whatever you're up to, although unfortunately it doesn't seem to have an option for automatic adjustment. There is an in-screen fingerprint sensor and also face unlock as well, although unfortunately it's just the slightly balls trusted face. Boo. As for performance, the Nokia 9 PureView uses Qualcomm Snapdragon 845 chipset, which is of course over a year old now. Why didn't they use the fresher 855? Well, HMD Global has been collaborating with Qualcomm in order to get the 845 working nicely with a special Imogen co-processor. More on that in a moment. And of course, as the 855 was only just launched at the arse end of 2018, there wasn't any time to switch things up. Still, while other new flagships are emerging with Qualcomm's latest chip on board, the 845 is still perfectly capable. The performance of the Nokia 9 is silky smooth, especially as there's no clunky overlay shoved there on top of Android. As for the battery life, you get a 3340 milliamp cell on board, and that supports a nice bit of Qi wireless charging as well, thanks to that glass backing. There's 6GB of RAM stuffed inside as well, and 128GB of storage as standard. Right, anyway, that's enough of that specs bollocks, onto the juicy stuff. As rumoured for quite some time, the Nokia 9 has 5 Canon 5 rear lenses with Zeiss branded optics slapped there on the back. And not a single camera bump in sight either, these things are perfectly flush with the surface of the phone. Now, most multi-lens cameras from the likes of Huawei and Samsung offer great flexibility by allowing you to flip through the various different lenses to get a great looking shot with minimal effort. However, the Nokia 9 PureView is a very different beast indeed. All 5 cameras work together simultaneously when taking shots rather than independently, and this setup will definitely best suit any photographers who really want to get creative, especially those who don't mind spending a bit of time editing and reshaping their captured images. The 2 central cameras housed directly beneath the Zeiss branding are color lenses, while the other 3 are monochrome. No wide angle or telephoto snappers here. The Nokia 9 PureView can individually control the exposure and white balance of those individual lenses to capture the ideal image dependent on the environmental conditions. And the final result is 12 megapixels in size at that 4:3 aspect ratio, or 9 megapixels in 16:9. A separate Imogen co-processor from optics expert Light actually manages each of those individual lenses, grabbing data from all of them before combining it and sending it off to Qualcomm's platform. Apparently, between 60 to 240 megapixels of information is gathered and combined. Having this separate co-processor really speeds things up compared with just using the ISP on the Qualcomm's platform, so that should mean great noise reduction, for instance, especially in those low light situations, while HDR results should really shine as well. With that multi-lens setup, the Nokia 9 PureView takes depth of field shots to the next level. In fact, not just the next level, it takes up to about 10 levels above. We're talking thousands of different layers captured here instead of just a handful, which is pretty typical for your standard smartphone. You can actually adjust the depth of field after taking a shot as well within the Google Photos app. This is an option that you do need to toggle on as it takes a bit more processing time, but it sounds like it's well worth leaving on. You can also capture photos in RAW format, of course, to really take advantage of all that captured data when editing. And as there's a trio of monochrome lenses slapped there on the back of the Nokia 9, there is unsurprisingly a monochrome mode for capturing moody images boasting brilliant texture. The Nokia 9 PureView's Pro controls have also been boosted by that funky hardware. So for instance, you can bump that exposure time all the way up to a mighty 10 seconds. Just make sure you've got a tripod handy, of course. As for video, resolutions of up to 4K are supported, and you can of course stream live to the likes of YouTube if that's your bag. You can actually customize all of the modes on offer, removing any that you don't like and switching up the order that they all appear in. And you've got all the usual Nokia camera shenanigans from previous handsets too. So for instance, there is a picture-in-picture mode for shooting with both the front and rear cameras simultaneously. Yeah, better mention that front-facing camera as well before we forget. Just the one lens this time, but you can shoot up to 20 megapixel photos of your wonderful face, as well as 4K Ultra HD resolution video. We don't have UK specific pricing for the Nokia 9 PureView just yet, but apparently it will start at $699 US. So basically it's gonna be 700 quid here, isn't it? As for availability, it will be ready very soon. So that is our full Nokia 9 PureView hands-on review. What do you reckon? That camera tech is definitely very interesting indeed. Certainly very exciting if you like to get creative with your photography. Definitely leave your comments down below. Don't forget to poke, subscribe, and ding that notifications bell, and have yourselves a lovely week, mother f***ers.